Hello. In this video, we're going to install a hard drive. And let's get rid of this. Yeah, this is what you'll see if you turn on your recorder and there's no hard drive. So yeah, we're going to put a hard drive in here. Pretty easy. We sell a decent number of DVRs and NVRs without hard drives. Sometimes maybe people have a spare hard drive that they want to install. Maybe they know where to get one for cheaper. Either way, it is not uncommon for us to sell these without any internal storage whatsoever. And if this does not have a hard drive, it can still display video in real time, and it can still connect over the internet if you want to see it over the internet. But it cannot record anything unless there's a little guy inside. Okay. This is relatively easy. There's just two cables involved, and if you purchased a DVR or NVR without a hard drive, we will not have screwed the top on. So if you get it and it's just loose, the top comes right off because there's no screws in there. That was intentional. That's the way we get them, so there's no reason to screw it together if we're not installing a hard drive in there. If you order it with a hard drive, then we will install the hard drive and screw the top shut. Okay, so that goes there. So basically we've got the inside of this guy. This is a SCN4, but this is what the inside of really any DVR is going to look like. And in terms of the... I didn't even grab a hard drive cable. Wait. Okay. I'm going to get hard drive cable from the inside of this guy. Here. Okay. Hey, look, a hard drive cable. I'm going to leave that here. You can leave that open. Okay, so the hard drive is going to require two cables to communicate with the recorder. This cable, multicolored, is going to communicate power from the DVR to the hard drive. And this smaller cable, it's usually red, sometimes it's orange, sometimes it's other colors. This is what's going to communicate data from the hard drive, no, from the recorder to the hard drive. So we have these two cables that are just going to be kind of sitting loose inside the recorder. When you install a hard drive, you want the DVR to be unplugged and off. Okay. And on here, you're basically going to take these two cables and install them in the hard drive in the only place where they fit in the hard drive. So the side of the hard drive, you see here, it's kind of grooved in such a way that it's only going to fit one way. So that fits in like this. Due to the way it's grooved out, I cannot install it this way. It won't fit. So this goes like this in here. Same with the data cable, the red one. It's grooved out so that you can only install it the correct way. Okay. That's plugged in right now. What you want to do before you plug in the cables is screw the hard drive down to the bottom of the DVR. That's what these four holes are for. Personally, whenever I hook one up just for our test bench, I never screw it down, but for long-term use, it's a good idea to screw the hard drive into the recorder. If you order one from us with a hard drive already installed, we will have installed it properly and screwed the DVR into the recorder. And now I'm going to power on the DVR right now. Hey, we turned on the DVR, and the hard drive is in there. Something else that I want to mention, it does make a difference what type of hard drive you install inside of the recorder. It does need to be 3.5 inches if it's a Zmodo NVR or DVR. In terms of the size, it needs to be SATA, And we highly recommend Western Digital Purple brand, which is, these are hard drives specifically designed for installation inside of DVRs. If you get a hard drive that is specifically designed to be installed in a computer, it will last not very long, because the computer-rated hard drives are intended to read and write to the hard drive not frequently. And just a computer, it's you don't really need to back up or access your hard drive on a very regular basis. However, in a DVR, the DVR is constantly feeding data to the hard drive, so it's running a marathon for as long as it's on. So for that reason, we recommend Western Digital Purple, between 500 gigabytes and 2 terabytes. There are a few recorders that support 3 terabyte hard drives, which Western Digital Purple does make a 3 terabyte hard drive now, but we recommend between 500 gigabytes and 2 terabytes. Okay, now it's on. When you first boot it up, when it has a brand new hard drive, it's going to say, it's going to prompt you with an error message and be like, hey, this hard drive is not formatted, do you want to format it? You click yes, it formats the hard drive, and then it will be ready to record. So we're going to open the menu. Pretty much any Zmodo DVR or NVR is going to have a default password of 6 ones, by the way. I don't want the startup guide. I want to go into the main menu, and from the main menu, we want to find the HDD manage screen or disk manage screen, and that will typically be under general settings or device settings, system settings. So, hey, look, general settings, and over here we see disk drive info. If you're using a different NVR or DVR, you just want to look for something along the lines of hard drive or storage or disk drive. Pretty self-explanatory there. And if the hard drive is connected and formatted, it will say connected. If it is connected and not yet formatted, that means it's not ready to record. It is in a format that is unrecognized by the DVR. And if it is connected and not formatted correctly, it will usually say status exception, status bad, status is something that other than connected. So if we want to format it, we highlight it and hit format. It's going to ask us for the password. 6 ones. All right. That's fantastic. Now the disk is being formatted, and we're just going to wait for that to happen for a minute. Alright, our NVR has finished formatting, and immediately after it finishes formatting the hard drive, it will come back online on the screen and display icons in the 4, or however many channels there are. So we're looking for something like this little guy here. This is just your basic, hey, I'm recording icon. If I do motion, then it will, yes, motion. Other DVRs will have a different but similar icon to indicate that recording is happening right now. Some of the DVRs will display a dot. Some DVRs will display a little film recorder-looking icon similar to the guy that was just here. If you see no icon up here, that means it's not recording. And there we have it. That's all we need on hard drives. And again, if you're curious, I'm using a new, we don't sell it yet even, it's really new, a 1080p Zmodo NVR system. So this is a higher video quality than what we've ever had before. I'm going to do this again, take a camera and aim it out the window because it's really cool. And really, really high definition. Look at the clouds and the cars and things. So, all right.